Hello everyone, DMFF here, and today we're going to be doing another one of my top 10 videos. Today, we're going to be doing a top 10 Sega Genesis games video. I really enjoyed Sega and their radical, outlandish 90s style. And today, we're really going to be going into that today with some of these pretty strange games, but you probably won't be surprised about number one. Although, it's a little bit of a cop-out. But anyway, check out the video. I hope you enjoy it.
Number 10, Golden Axe. Ah yes, a wonderful side-scrolling beat-em-up action game that originally actually came out in arcades, but it was later ported to the Genesis and is very, very, very close to the original on the arcade, other than an extra level and a dueling mode. But this game is one of my favorite beat-em-ups, mainly because it's fantasy-themed and it's really silly. Now, you can choose three different people, and everybody has magic. Magic wipes out the whole screen, and each character has slightly different magic. The barbarian has earth magic, the dwarf, he has lightning magic, and the warrior woman has fire magic. You can actually get more power by collecting magic potions from these little, I don't know what they are, gremlins, sprites, little annoying men. I remember them very fondly from my childhood, and they'd move around and I'd have a hard time hitting them, and they always bugged me as a kid, but you know, I always came back to this game and had a lot of fun playing co-op with my friends. There were different vehicle type things, like these dinosaurs or whatever they are. You could ride them and use them in battle. And you could knock your friend off of it, and they could do the same to you. Yep, it's a dog-eat-dog world out there. But yeah, guys, check out Golden Axe. It's really fun if you really like that beat-em-up style. Number 9, Vector Man. Now this game was kind of like Sega's answer to Donkey Kong, as they were using pre-rendered 3D models for this game as well, and it actually looks quite good on the system still. This is a pretty straightforward action platformer game where you can shoot, jump, do all sorts of cool things, and transform into different forms to swim, to lay bombs. You have all sorts of cool abilities in this game. It isn't like my favorite platformer, but it's a solid entry in the Sega Genesis era, and if you really like the Sega Genesis and haven't given this game a try, I highly recommend it. There's about 16 levels in this game, so it's a pretty quick playthrough once you get the hang of it. Number 8, Gunstar Heroes. This Contra-like game on the Sega Genesis is actually one of my favorite shoot-em-ups of all time. This game is incredibly fun, offers a co-op mode, and on top of having four different types of guns, you can combine two together to create a whole new weapon. It was so cool back in the day, being able to combine homing with machine gun to have homing machine gun shots. Holy moly, that was super cool as a kid. This game is pretty linear with the left to right strategy of shooting things up, but things start to change a little bit with some minecart, with like a minecart level. But this game is super spectacular. I highly recommend it if you like Contra. The co-op mode is super fun to play with a friend. If you like shoot 'em ups, give this one a try. Number 7, Sonic Spinball. Oh my goodness, you must be thinking, what kind of person puts this on their top 10 Genesis games? Me, I do. I loved this game. I remember when it came out and we were all waiting for it because it was the newest Sonic game coming out for Christmas. So It was gotten, and it was unlike any other pinball game I've played before. It was super fun and had that Sonic attitude to it, but everyone knows that infamous options music. Turn it off. Okay. But, yes, some of the music in this game is pretty off. Mainly because they were going to be using Sonic 1 and 2 music in this game, and they would have had to pay royalties to the original composer of Sonic 1 and 2. They didn't want to do that, so Sega had them change the music pretty quickly toward the end of the game's release. So, I love this game. But if you want to play this game, I highly recommend turning it up to max speed. Doing so makes it a lot more smooth and makes the game playable. It's super fun. I explored this game so much as a child, and sometimes even still play it to this day, just to relax and have some fun with some Sonic Spinball. Number 6. Echo the Dolphin. This is a very strange adventure game that its smooth graphics and gameplay had me captivated from day one. I actually had a friend that had this before I even had a chance to play it, and they introduced it to me. The mechanics are so fun and totally unlike anything else ever seen before. You play as a dolphin. You swim like a dolphin. You can also send out calls to other life, just like a dolphin would. You travel all over the ocean. Basically, all of your friends and family in the bay that you live in get sucked up by some storm, and you have to go see what the hell happened. Well, many twists and turns. You have to go up to air to breathe because you're a mammal. This game is so in-depth, man. I highly recommend you give it a try if you never have, but this game, super fun, give it a shot. Number 5. Earthworm Jim. Yes, I know, Earthworm Jim was released on the Super Nintendo as well, but it came out on the Genesis first. It was ported over to the Super Nintendo. Now this game kind of plays on a bunch of tropes of the 90s, kind of making fun of all of the tropes of the 90s, while being an excellent platforming shooter. Earthworm Jim, he is an earthworm in some kind of suit that allows him to run and shoot his gun. Really, really crunchy, really, really 90s. It just feels grungy, but it's so much fun. I always find myself coming back to the Genesis version of the game just because of the nostalgia. I played that one first, because it came out first. But you find yourself going to different levels, a junkyard, hell, all sorts of strange things. But this game is really tough too. If you like difficulty, and you like platforming shooters that quite aren't the same to like Contra and such, this is a great game for you. Number 4. Castlevania Bloodlines. The one and only Castlevania game on the Genesis. And I really do enjoy me some Castlevania, but this game is quite good. It takes place in the early 1900s, well after, I believe, someone that was a descendant of the Belmont family finally killed Dracula, and then World War I happened, and the world fell into darkness, which made for people to want to resurrect some vampires for some reason, but that's the story to that. So you are not actually part of the Belmont family in this game. You are actually going to be playing as John Morris and Eric Licard. John Morris is a distant descendant of the famed Belmont and Morris families. And he is still a vampire hunter. Imagine that one. But an Elizabeth Bartley is going to be resurrected a niece to Dracula. She gets resurrected. Dracula gets resurrected. But you defeat him at the end, just like you do every other time. This game is really fun. I really like the aesthetic to this game. It's different than the other Castlevania games. And it has that Genesis attitude. Give it a try if you really like Castlevania games. Number 3. Sonic the Hedgehog 2. Ah, finally. Another Sonic entry that isn't Sonic Spinball. Just kidding, guys. But Sonic 2 is regarded by many to be the best Sonic game ever made, and you know what? It is a really good game. And, you know, the best standalone game. This game highly improves upon what the first game did. The first game had one fantastic level, and then the rest of them were not very good. However, Sonic 2 has many memorable levels, with fantastic settings, and it was just super fun and over the top, and you became Super Sonic for the first time. That was epic. Finally, after trying many, many times playing this game, I was able to collect the 7 emeralds as a child and become Super Sonic for the first time at Oil Ocean. One of the worst stages in the game. But I love the music, just listen to it. Plus, this game did end with some of the hardest boss fights in the series, as you get no rings, really, and Metal Sonic into Eggman at the end is pretty tough, and is a sudden spike in difficulty that not many expect, but it was something that I really pushed for, to defeat him when I was a kid. This game is dripping with 90s. And wonderful Genesis aesthetic, along with beautiful music that only the Sonic team could do to make the Genesis sound good, as that sound chip was not nearly as good as the SNES's. But you all know Sonic 2. Give it a play again. It's a classic. Number 2. Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3. Yes, I am including Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3 on here as my number 2 spot. This game I played almost more than any other game. All my friends loved to play fighting games. And, you know, the best version of Mortal Kombat was on the Genesis. Being able to have blood and gore? We loved that. We didn't want that kiddie stuff. We didn't want the lack of blood on the SNES. We wanted that real blood. We wanted it to look good. Plus, you could unlock Smoke and Ermac, first released in this game. Plenty of characters to play as here. Really, really solid animations and gameplay. And great frame rate. This was the game that my friends and I would go home after school and fight against each other day in and day out. My mom actually forbid me from playing it because of how graphic it was, and I still played it. That's gotta say something. Or that I'm just a 90s kid. But anyway, guys, go play the best version of Mortal Kombat 3, Ultimate Mortal Kombat 3, on the Sega Genesis. Sega! Number 1! Sonic 3 and Knuckles. Now, I know. I'm copping out hard here. I combined 2 games into 1 game for the number 1 spot. And, you know, let's be honest. Sonic 3 was pretty lackluster by itself. Sonic and Knuckles was not as lackluster, but still pretty lackluster by itself. But Sonic and Knuckles had the capability to have a cartridge attached to the top. you attach Sonic 3 to the top, and oh my god, what is this? It becomes like an extra length video game that introduces the Master Emerald and the Super Emeralds. So then you can collect them all and become Hyper Sonic and Hyper Knuckles and Super Tails? Sign me up. Sign me up right away. It was one of the coolest things as a kid, and now, knowing that it was just a marketing scheme by, Sega, it's kinda crappy. But back when I was a kid and that didn't matter, holy moly, this was insane. Being able to play through from the beginning of Angel Island all the way to the Death Egg as Sonic, and then defeat Eggman as Hyper Sonic was one of the most hype moments of my life. Plus, this game finally included save capabilities, so you didn't have to try to beat it in one sitting. This is my favorite Sonic game of all time. When you combine Sonic 3 and Knuckles together as they were meant to be played, it becomes the best Sonic experience ever to be had. And yes, I know a lot of people really love Sonic Mania, and I love it too. It's great to see a return to form, but I don't like it as much as I like Sonic 3 and Knuckles. There's just a charm to this game that just feels wonderful. This was peak Sega Genesis and peak Sonic, in my opinion. And that's why it is in my number one spot. Please, if you have not played the two games together, I highly recommend it. It will be the best Sonic experience you've ever had, if you like the 2D Sonics. That was my top 10 favorite games for the Sega Genesis. Were there any games there that you thought were sorely missed that should have been there? What was your list? Let me know down in the comments below. Anyway, guys, hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you next time.